Discovered yet ancient entities that are hard to find, but the sheer power of one will blow your mind. Powered by a massive black hole at their core, incredible phenomena we can't ignore. Quasars, they are quasars. Why does a quasar burn so bright? Extreme hot gases generate light. Quasars, they are quasars. Brightest objects in the universe, throughout the cosmos they're interspersed. Their luminosity makes them hard to miss. Bright ejection jets and accretion disks, billions of times more massive than our sun. I can't wait to go and meet one. Quasars, they are quasars. It's time to meet, yes, it's time to go and meet a quasar.
I'm Quasar J0529-4351. My luminosity is roughly 500 trillion times the luminosity of your sun. With an enormous accretion disk and bright ejection jet, I'm the biggest, fastest growing, most luminous quasar yet. My black hole is the fastest growing black hole ever found to date. It increases in mass by about the equivalent of eating one sun per day. I'm so far away, it took my light over 12 billion years to reach you. In the Pictor constellation, my growth and expansion will continue.
I'm J0005-0006, one of the smallest quasars ever discovered to exist.
And I'm J0303-0019, another extremely small quasar that your scientists did find.
We have two of the most primitive, oldest black holes ever uncovered,
leading astronomers to believe that we're first-generation quasars that were discovered. We are both dust-free, no stardust for you to see. About 13 billion light-years away is where you can find me.
And me.
Quasi Stellar radio source for quasar. That is the type of object they are. Far away but brighter than any star or any other objects discovered so far. Extremely rare and hard to find, but the sheer power of one will blow your mind. Powered by a massive black hole at their core, incredible phenomena we can't ignore. Quasars, they are quasars. Why does quasar burn so bright? Thermal radiation lights up the night. Quasars, they are quasars. Brightest objects in the universe, throughout the cosmos they're interspersed. Their luminosity makes them hard to miss. Bright ejection jets and accretion disks, billions of times more massive than our sun. I can't wait to go and meet one. Quasars, they are quasars. It's time to meet, yes, it's time to go and meet a quasar.
I am Quasar CTA-102, a blazer whose ejection jet is pointed directly at you. But not to worry, I am about 8 billion light years away, in the Pegasus constellation, and that's where I will stay. In 1963, an astrophysicist from Russia thought he uncovered proof of alien life because of an unidentified radio signal he discovered. Now scientists know I'm a quasar, but he thought I was an extraterrestrial civilization. The folk rock band The Birds wrote a song about it in 1967.
I'm a double quasar, a very rare find. I'm known as J0749+2255. Two quasars very close to each other, you see. 3 billion years ago, we were part of two merging galaxies. But that's not all Hubble telescope could find. It also spotted J0841+4825, another double quasar that was part of two galaxies that merged together. And now our two already merged galaxies are colliding with each other.
There's one more fascinating wonder to meet. A special phenomenon, a real treat. Even more spectacular than a regular quasar is an incredible cosmic structure that is colossal and bizarre.
We are huge, LQG. Not a single quasar, we are 73. We make up one of the largest known celestial structures in the universe. Across 4 billion light years, we're interspersed. Quasars, we are quasars. If you were driving at the speed of light, it would take 4 billion years to
across from side to side.
Quasars, we are quasars.
Luminosity makes them hard to miss. Bright ejection jets and accretion disks. Billions of times more massive than our sun.
Now you've had a chance to meet one quasar. We are quasars.